It was a frustratingly familiar experience for England fans this year. Trudging out of a stadium after a turgid performance. Only this time it was at the World Cup, with so much at stake. Even Captain Harry Kane couldn't be relied on for a goal against the Americans at the start or right at the end of their second match in Qatar. How close the Americans had come to scoring, with Weston McKennie striking over and Christian Pulisic only denied by the crossbar as England held on. Frustration for fans at home, so buoyed by the six goals scored against Iran in that opener. At Al Bayt Stadium, the goalless draw was greeted with boos from England fans.
Of course, I want our fans to go home happy, and I want our fans at home to have a smile on their faces, so we haven't quite managed to achieve that.
But we've got another game left, and everyone else has got less points than us in the group, so let's be positive about it.
Hopefully they pull it out of the bag for the Wales game and get a bit of spark back.
It's a worry, really, when we've got Wales next game. They've got nothing to lose now after the Iran defeat.
Most England fans would say Southgate out.
This was typical of a dismal display seen from Gareth Southgate's side this year, but it would still take a heavy defeat against Wales in a Battle of Britain on Tuesday to stop England going through to the last 16.
Twice Wales conceded late on to lose 2-0 to Iran. They must now beat England to have any hope of reaching the knockout phase at their first World Cup in 64 years. Now it's recovery time for England and Wales, with both needing to raise their game for the showdown next week to extend their stays in Qatar. Rob Harris, Sky News, Al Bayt Stadium in Qatar.